What up, son? Word.
Yeah. To all the killers and the $100 billers.
Yo, villains.
For real, niggas who ain't got no feelings. Feelings. Check it out now.
We're here with John Mazzotta. He's fighting April 20th, Pinnacle Fighting Championships card. Dom, we just watched you train, lay a whooping on your partners there. Except for that black belt guy. You know, he's pretty good.
Yeah, Teddy, he's my guy.
Describe like your style of fighting and movement for people who've never watched you, or like for our blind listeners.
I came in to mixed martial arts as Taekwondo background. So I'm like more stand up of a fighter, but for some reason in my fights, I was taking people down and submitting them. So, I mean, I like to think I'm an all around mixed martial artist. I think if you want to be a successful mixed martial artist, now you have to be all around, because that's what everybody is. You know, it's not style versus style anymore. It's a sport. It's mixed martial arts. So, I like to think that I'm an all around mixed martial artist. And actually, I like to think that really, I don't think that I'm better at anything else. You know, I think everything's pretty even. You know, sometimes go through times where my wrestling's getting better, and then just do take off because I learn a couple new things. But really, I think it's just
You're fighting Jeremy Pender. He's also a jack of all trades kind of guy, right, Jeremy Pender?
Yeah, that's what I'm
saying. What are your ideas about your opponent here? Like, what do you think about him?
To be honest with you, I don't have any idea about him, really. I've never watched him fight.
Really?
Yeah, I don't watch my opponents.
Do you ever watch your opponents fight?
The only time I watch my opponents is if I've seen them fight and I didn't know I was going to fight them.
Oh, I gotcha. And is there a reason for that? You just like the surprise factor? Or like, surprise,
I don't really think it's necessary. My coaches watch it and they tell me, this is what we're going to work on. And then we game plan that way.
Oh, cool.
I don't really see there's any reason to watch it. Because I just have to do it. What my coaches tell me to do, and just try to execute that. So.
Interesting. Okay.
I don't even know what he looks like, to be honest with you.
Yeah, he's like a white guy.
I just know he's kind of tall.
Yeah, he's got like those intense eyes, Anyway.
It's good, man. So, I had a little problem a couple weeks. During the camp, I hurt my neck from the last fight. Luckily, the rehab center, my wrestling coach, Isaac Greenlee, is a chiropractor. And the rehab center, that's where we're at right now, actually.
Wow, this is pretty convenient. So after you train and get beaten up, you just step through that glass door.
Well, actually, after my coach, Isaac, beats me up and then, twists me up, he then adjusts me and fixes me up.
It sounds like a pyramid scheme you got going on here.
He does have a little bit of a scam going on there. He fixed me up. Training was, I was kind of scared I was going to be able to fight, because I wasn't going to be able to train to the level that I have to. And the rehab center really fixed me up. I mean, I'm having a little bit of problems, but training is really good. Me and Francis, we were just at Gurgel's. We were at Gurgel's in Cincinnati over the weekend. We got to train with a lot of top guys. Taylor Ruskin is a good friend of mine out there. He's a little top level pro. Justin Edwards was out there. Isaac Steele,
Did you see Zoila Gurgel?
No, Zoila and George weren't there. They were in Cali training for Zoila's next fight. But we still got some good work done with some good guys.
Cool.
We lined with Mad Dog, and we've been going training back and forth at their place. They come here on Saturdays. We go there on Tuesdays, and it's kind of our new training partners, kind of affiliates. And Francis is 145 pounds. Great training partner for me. We're we're really helping each other out. He's probably, the best sparring partner I've ever had. He's really dedicated. He's going to go far in the sport, and I think we're going to be able to go far together.
Awesome, man. Do you have any, like, special moves you're hoping to pull off one day, like a flying uppercut? You know, like, there's some footage of you doing, the Showtime kick, some spinning wheel kicks.
Well, yeah.
What can we hope to see? What do you hope to see? What is
this fight?
And this fight. This fight, this guy's he seems like a brawler. Jeremy Penner's a real brawler. He wants to drag you out in that deep end of brawling in the pool where people just brawl.
This is what I knock him out of the head kick thing. I've always wanted. I drop a lot of people in practice with a spinning back kick, but I can't seem to ever land it in the fight.
Like back to the gut?
Yeah.
Gotcha.
And, I mean, that would be cool to knock him out, because that's kind of my Taekwondo's signature kick. So to land that, that would be cool.
So is it, do you do a spinning back kick or a turning side kick, as they say?
Yes.
Okay. I just wanted,
Yeah, it's the same.
I think all of our viewers have seen that Joe Rogan video of Joe Rogan teaching GSP.
Yeah, it's basically exactly.
Gotcha.
But Joe Rogan is from Taekwondo, and that's where
the kid comes from. Cool. Do you have any sponsors that you'd like to thank?
Yeah. First and foremost is the Rehab Center. They have a location in Clarion, a location in Murfreesboro, location in Harlem, location in Katini. Badass Pads, Club Fitness, 24-hour fitness. Bermuda, Joe's Place.
What's Bermuda?
It's a bar. Stella's, another bar. Joe's Place, another bar. On.
Give you free booze after you get all beaten up. Like, here's a shot.
Yeah, they're good friends of mine. Right. They're good people. Who else got me?
Biggest Steve's?
Biggest Steve's, of course.
Didn't that guy, disarm some knife-wielding attacker? Is that the right? Is that missing the other shirt company?
I don't know.
Jeremiah,
yeah. I don't know.
Yeah, I what?
There's, Toast.
Toast?
Yeah, it's,
It's like a... Oh, I see it. I'll zoom in on it.
Yeah, it's a... Oh. It's like a icy
heart
or whatever.
Gotcha. Okay.
Also, Brain Armor.
What's that?
It's a fish oil company.
Are you making these up as you go along? There's a lot of sponsors here. Wow, that's incredible. That's amazing. Well, thanks a lot for talking.
I'm still looking at my coaches.
Yeah.
And my, all my gyms. Joe's Taekwondo, the mayor's family, and anybody around here, kids, older, younger, whatever. Send them to Joe's Taekwondo if they want to learn martial arts. The Matt Factory, we're at Eddie Vincent Jiu-Jitsu, and Paul Peterson, Boston.
Well, thanks a lot, Dom, and we hope to see you in action on April 20th, and maybe use that spinning back kick, maybe not, maybe something
maybe
wild.
Not.
All right, thanks a lot.
You don't need cages, you don't need rings, you don't need all kind of bags and shit. We got one bag, two bags, we got mats, we got a set of pads, and we got the best fighters in Pittsburgh. That's what you need at a gym. I'm watching the series next.